Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Micks Mowers, and in today's episode we're going to be taking a look at the Marksman generator. I've got the McCulloch up and running, which is cool. I have tried tuning the carburetor on that and it's still just a little bit dopey, so it may want some gaskets and diaphragms put in there as well, so I might treat it to that at some point. I'll give it another run up in a couple of days to see if it's cleared its own fault, and also put the filter back in as well, which the screen it was missing. So that's done. We're going to look at this Marksman, as I keep saying. On my live stream just the other day, some of you guys wanted to see me to try and get it unseized, and it turned out it wasn't seized at all. I think it was just gummed up, pretty much, just been sat for so long. I was able just to move the flywheel ever so slightly with a screwdriver, and it freed itself. I put some petrol down the head and it actually fired, but I can't get any fuel to come down through the carburetor. So I'll get it up on the bench and get the carburetor off, have a look at what we can do, and see if this little generator will run, and then hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll actually power something up, which would be quite cool. It's a two-stroke Jenny, 50-to-1 mix, and it should be quite good if I can get it to run. So without further ado, let's get down and dirty and let's check out this Marksman generator. Right, so here it is, and as I say, I was able just to get a screwdriver or something similar in the back of a flywheel and just tease the fins of the flywheel, and then all of a sudden I was able to pull it over. It's got compression, all that sort of good stuff, but the carburetor itself will not release any fuel when I undo the bottom screw to a plug. So I've got to at least make a start to get the carburetor off. I've got my toolbox a bit closer today, so I shouldn't keep nipping off the tools. Now, I worked on one similar to this not so long ago that a builder bought in. What do you do for a living? He does garage doors, and he used it just to power a few tools up. So I'm basing my experience on that, and hopefully we can get it to run. Would be good. Of course, it's not the end of the world, because it may run, but it still may not power anything, and that could have been the reason why they got rid of it. But we'll have to see. Let me try and get this bolt out. That's it. Oh, the carburetor looks absolutely hideous. Absolutely blown to bits. The carburetor looks so much gunk in there. Just to get that off is going to be a mission, and get it clean. It's a bit of an air filter there, not much. I need to get some 10mm bolts onto there. That'll be one of my first things I've got to do. That's 10mm, that might be an 8. Yeah, it's going to be an 8. Okay. Let's go down a size then. Let's try that one. That fits lovely. Put a small bar on top of that. Say this carburetor, I can see it from here, looks absolutely horrendous. So much corrosion in here. I'll show you guys in a minute what I can actually see, though it's been sat for a little while as this. Let me just show you what I'm looking at. So there's the throat of a carburetor. As you can see, absolutely hideously got so much stuff in there. It's not in a good way at all. So we'll start the strip down and see what we can come up with. That's about the best I can do at the moment. So this little tiny plate comes off. A couple of big bolts there. They should actually hold a carburetor in place. I don't want to pull it too hard, because I don't want to ruin any gaskets that may be behind there. So don't just pull these out. The plate has a flat spot on the bottom, which is the way it goes. This is definitely going to be a job for the ultrasonic cleaner. I'm hoping the carburetor's not too far gone. But even that bolt's corroded. Come on, baby, here you come. That's that one out. That's all loose. That plate should drop away. I've got a choke lever to move out of the way as well, which is that one. And what else we've got behind here? I'm not seeing any other. Well, there's 10mm down here or 8mm down here. I can see that. So there's one there, which is going to be a bit of a pickle to get to because it's sunk within the plastic. I need to get something on that so I can get that out. I don't know if that's turning or not. Yeah, I think it is. So I'll be putting a washer on that as well, just to hold that in place a bit better so I can get onto the head of the bolt, because it's eaten into the plastic. Oh, it's right in there too. That's it, it's better. Eaten into the plastic. Just couldn't remove it. And it's got a captive nut on it, so that's good. With that little bolt out. That's a smaller one. I can now manipulate this a bit more. Got a bit of wiring to remove. I don't want to go mad and remove all the wiring. Just try and push it to one side, might be good. And that'll give me a closer look at the carburetor itself. I'll try and spin it round so you guys can also see. Otherwise, there's no point in you guys watching a video. And there's a carburetor sat in there. So the fuel pipe is actually already off. That came off yesterday. When I was mucking about a bit on my live stream, the pipe is absolutely rock solid. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do a lot with that. It looks like it's about ready to snap, but we should see. So to take this carburetor off, you're looking at a couple of 8mm bolts. In fact, it could be four. I think there shouldn't be anything else holding that on. That should be loose. I've already removed the bolts. And the gasket there, which I don't want to really, I don't want to upset. So I'm just going to try and get some in here just to help knock that carburetor loose. I might just get my little tinging hammer. There it goes. And nice and gently with it. Got a bit of linkage to remove as well. There goes a gasket, that's all in one piece, which is good. And just lift the carburetor, lift the linkage up, and then tip the carburetor around, should be the key, like so. Move that little tiny, and I've got a little tiny spring on there as well to remove, which also goes onto a governor arm. So that's nice and simple and straightforward. Leave it on the governor. And there it is. There's our carburetor. As you see by the back of it, absolutely trashed. So that's gonna take some serious cleaning. But from what I can see, the choke flap works. The throttle flap isn't as free as I would like. But we'll get it up on the bench, we'll strip it off and see what we can come up with. Okay, so we've got the carb now. I don't foresee there being a great deal of fuel in here, because I couldn't get anything to drain down the other day. So I will put a rag down just to protect this cover for now, just in case, but I can't see it. That must be a 10mm. Let's see if that'll come loose. Yeah, it will. Oh, I'm seeing some bits and pieces come out already. No fuel as of yet though. But it does look wet in here, which is good. No fuel inside. Let's have a look at this bowl. Try and save that O-ring because I don't have a spare for it. Oh my word. Yeah, that's proper. That is a proper carburetor. Look at that in there. There's no way that float would ever move properly on its own. I can't even see the main jet. And all that stuff in there. Look at it. All that yummy stuff. So that's all got to come out. That's no good to be in there. That's got to be cleaned out. So what I'm going to do first off, I'm just going to get a little tiny tub and put some neat petrol in just to loosen this stuff up before I continue. Right, I've got a nice little tub of neat petrol. That can go into there. Now I'll try and find the pin that holds the float on. It's going to be in here somewhere. Look where it is. That's it's going to come out. Yeah, it's come out. And very carefully remove the float. And then in there somewhere will be a needle, which I don't want to break. I don't have any spares. Hopefully it will come out without too much fuss. There she goes. There's a needle. Now in here also will be a main jet of some description. Let's give it a bit of a birthday. So I'm just trying to expose that main jet. Still can't see it. But I know it's in there. Come here. This stuff is really, really right in there. Let me get some WD-40 spray on it as well in a minute. There's so much stuff coming out of here. Let's get a bit of WD-40 spray. Put that through it. I'm not seeing anything going coming down through the bottom of the jet yet. There's carburetor maybe too far gone. Until we have a look at that main jet, we won't know. I can't even see it, by blimey. It's in there somewhere. Can't even see it. Let me try and force the needle down through it. That should be big enough. There it goes. Let's open that throttle up. Yeah, I can see that going through now. Now, I would ideally like to get this jet out if it comes out, but at the moment I can't even see the head of it. It may be too far corroded for me to do anything with it. But I am now at least getting a hole through it. Oh, I can see it now. There it is. It's just exposed itself and it looks like a pressed one. They're not designed to come out. That's all blocked in there. The whole carburetor is blocked. Absolutely jammed up tight. So I'm going to do a bit of manual cleaning first just to try and get the carburetor to. See, that won't even go through there. How crazy is that? That's the inlet. I can't get anything to run through. So I need to get a bit of bit of stuff working through here. Bit of air compressing. So I can't even get any fuel coming through the inlet at the moment. I don't know if that actually unscrews or not. It should do. But yeah, I'm going to compress it. Air compressor. I'm going to try and remove that O-ring if I can. I don't have no spares for it, as I said. So I don't want to be using any carb cleaner if I can help it. Give it a good general clean up and I'll come back and then we'll put it in the bath. Okay, the carburetor is now in a bit more of a happier place. I've removed all the jets out of it, best I can. I cannot get that middle jet out. It does not want to come. I'm not going to force it. So I'll have to just try and make do with the cleaning. I've managed to get all the ports all now clear. So that's one good thing. And also I've managed to get some fluid now through the intake, which it wasn't doing. Took this jet out as well, and this jet is completely and utterly bunged. Can't see daylight through any of these, so that needs to go into the cleaner as well once I compress it out. The whole lot is absolutely shot to bits. So it's not good, people, it's not good. So I just want to remove some of this stuff out of this bowl before I put it into the cleaner, just to give it half a fighting chance. I don't want to have all this stuff in there whilst I'm cleaning it. Won't be removing the flood screw just yet. I want to get all the gunk out of it first, give it a clean, and then I will draw that. Yeah, it's not very good, people. It's one of the worst carburetors I've seen all year. But one of my fellow colleagues at work, he actually had the worst carburetor to date. The whole thing was full up with jelly, literally full to the brim. It was absolutely crazy. Right, that's a bit better. I can work with that now. Ish. Right, so let me now just get the old ultrasonic cleaner fired up, get it up to temperature. I use boiling water straight out of the kettle, and it comes at around about 60 to 70 degrees, somewhere in there. And what I'm then going to do is give us a good clean. I'm going to give it a much bigger clean. I'll give it about half hour each side, this one, because it really does need a good clean. It's absolutely shocking, so that's what I'm going to do. So give us 5 minutes just to get the old ultrasonic cleaner fired up, and then I'll come back to you. Okay, so that's the carb now into the cleaner. I'm going to get about 20 minutes each side. It's at 79 degrees at the minute. That's straight out the kettle. I go between 60 and 70 normally. That is quite hot in there. But to be fair, it's got to be quite hot to get all that stuff out of there. So I'll when it's done its first 20 minutes, I'll come back and we'll have a look, turn it over, and give it another go. All right, that's cool. That's my mate Taff just rocked up for his Allen Pro strimmer. That was good. Nice to see him for a little while. Always nice to see a fellow mower bloke. Right, let's get a rag here. And let's see how this is doing. This has had 20 minutes each side. It's still sat around about 80 degrees, which is quite warm to what I normally do them. But let's have a look to see what we're looking like. Let's turn that power off first before I electrocute myself. That's always a good thing, I suppose. All right, let's have a little look-ski. It's very hot. All right, it looks pretty good on first inspection. There's some bits in the bottom I've got to fish out in a minute. But that water's as murky as you like, and it's got a funny smell to it too. So what I'm going to do, I'll just give it a quick little draft with the air compressor. I'll blow all these suds out. I'll get the needles and what have you out of there as well. And then we'll have a closer examination, see what this carburetor looks like. Right, that's now out the cleaner. There are still some very, very small amounts of corrosion flakes on here, which I'll try and get off with a wire brush. But it is actually where the alleys has been reacting with the fuel. So I'll try and get most of that off, but a lot of it won't come. It is actually now, the carburetor is damaged. But I'm hoping the rest of the carburetor itself is okay. The choke wasn't, the throttle was not running freely, but as you can now see, that's now running as free as a bell. which is good, and the choke was working anyway, but that was particularly sticky, so that's now doing its job. Let's have a quick look inside the bulb. Yeah, the bulb's come up really well. Very happy with the bulb. Again, there's a bit of corrosion still in there. I should just get a wire brush in there, just knock some of it off if I can, but it is what it is. The main jet is now clear and looks to be very clean. So I'm happy with that. Double check that is clear. It does look clear. Yeah, it is. These were all bunged up, these were. So that's good. Right, I'm happy with that so far. So now we can start to reassemble. Need to double check this needle first, make sure that spring's still working, which it is. That's good. So needle in first. That goes into the carb. And then we want the make sure you're in shot, yeah you are. Then we want this float that just sits on top, and then the pin goes through there and holds all that up. If it'll go back in the hole, it should do because it's been cleaned. It was particularly hard to get out of it. That's better to put it that way. There she goes. Doesn't want to go all the way through, but it will do with just a little bit of therapy. Let's just use a little hammer. That's it. Let's try and blow through that now. Nothing through there. Lift the float up. Or nothing. Nothing at all. Which tells me that needs cleaning out a bit more inside the needle chamber. Is it still a bit sticky in there? I'll make it a bit of a shot of WD-40 in there as well. No, that should go. Yeah, that's running. Let's have a quick little glance in there. Yeah, there's a little tiny bit of gunk on the inside. It looks to be from the alley. That's just inside here on this wall. I can just about see it. Let me get my light on it. Just see it. Where is it? There it is. Little tiny flakes of stuff. Don't want to go too mad because this is brass and you don't want to be upsetting this. Because if you score it, then it's never going to to work properly again. So you need to go very, very gently. You can put cotton buds in there as well, but it actually needs cleaning out, scraping out. That looks better. There's a few little tiny bits in there. Right, let's give that a shot of the old WD-40. Just to help that along its way. Okay, so a bit of WD-40 now. Where's my needle gone? Here it is there. It does seem to be relatively loose. Yeah, that's not holding. Put that back on. And the pin back in. That's better. There you go. That's working. Just want to try and push that pin through a bit more if I can, would be nice. Just to secure that float a bit more. I don't want to go too mad, I'm going to break the side of his ear off. There it goes. Literally just a bit of crud in there. I'm happier now. There. That's working. Good. Right. The bowl can go on now, and before I do that, I just want to remove this other screw here, which is what allows you to flood the carburetor should you need to bring any fuel down. Now, it is only just a screw that has got a port one end, and that goes all the way through the carburetor. So I just want to get some WD-40 and just squirt that through there. Just make sure that crevice is clean, which it is. And that can go straight back in. Which one? This one here. Lost it for a minute. So that can be done up nice and tight for now. And then that can go back onto the carburetor. Now this needs to be the right way around, so it's choke at the front, and then it's got to be on that way around. I've got to put the O-ring back on as well. Now just save the O-ring before I introduce any carb cleaner. So that can all go on. And just sit that down on top. It wants to go about there somewhere. And then that can then be done up. The state of that. Don't introduce anything into this carburetor now it's been cleaned. Get wire brush on that. So now it's been cleaned. Really don't want to bring anything else into this carburetor. It's had a hard enough life as it is by the looks of it. That can now go on there. Happy with that. And that can now be done up. Which is a 10 mil. Not too tight, because you'll strip that thread out and that'll be the end of that game. So that's that. And I've now got the idle screw to put back in, and this jet here, that one goes in, and that goes all the way up tight on this one. So the carburetor is in much better condition than what it was. That's without a doubt. It does look so much better. So that one was tight, and then we then have the idle screw, which is this one, and that goes in and do it all the way up. And I did make a note somewhere of how many turns this has got to come out, but it's not life or death. You can always adjust it later on, but I like to try and set them to where they were. The idle was, let me just go and double check. Right, the idle was 3.5 turns, so all the way down to there, and that's 1, 2, 3.5, and that's roughly where the idle was set to. And then you've got this other little kiddie, and that goes down the side of the carburetor into here, and again do that all the way up, and this was 1 and a bit turns back out. It should be just enough just to allow the fuel to go through that little tiny hole. I do it all the way up, which is about there, and it's 1 and a bit. So there's 1, and there's your bit. That's about right. Right, so happy with that. That carburetor is now has been fully serviced, fully cleaned, and hopefully in a much better state where we can actually get some fuel down through it now and make it work. I need to try and find a bit of hose pipe now for this, because this pipe is absolutely solid. It's had it. So I don't really want to use it really, so I need to find a bit of spare pipe. So give us 2 ticks and I'll be back. Well, I've got a bit of donor pipe. This has come off another lawnmower, and it looks to be, it's slightly thicker in diameter in pipe, but I think it will actually fit on this carb. So yeah, that got me lovely. So just going to measure this to size, cut it, and it's a lot more pliable, this one here. So let's go to the back there. Let's get a bit more than what it actually needs. And then when we go to actually fit it, we can always trim it off if need be. It's got a set of hose clamps as well on it, which I can keep. to one side. I might even try and use the original ones that come with it. We shall see. Right, let's get this over to the table, and we'll see if we can't get this carburetor fitted to the machine and go from there. Right, so we're back on the bench with the old generator. There's my new bit of pipe, which is quite pliable, so that's quite good. I'm going to hook that up to the fill tap side first. I'll try and get in here without the without having to move the pull cord assembly would be good. The fuel tap's turned off, so no fuel should come out. That goes on there lovely. I'm going to get a set of clamps to put onto that as well, which in hindsight I probably should have put that on initially, which is what I'll do now. Oh, that's tight. Let's put that back onto there. Now I'm not going to clean the pipe of a tap because that actually runs quite well. Let me try and get this tap on, this clip on. It's going to be a bit fiddly, so I want you guys to see at the same time. That's it. That's going. Right, that's gone on. That's on there nice and tight. That's that bit done. We can now move on to the carburetor itself. So the carburetor is a gasket down here, which is already on. We've got to fit the spring on. That goes through the same hole as the governor. And then tip the carburetor back and hook up all of that stuff. So that's all on there now and working as it should do. That all goes into place there. I'm going to hook up the petrol now onto the carburetor. We'll need to put another clamp on first before I do any of that. I may just have to trim this pipe off a touch, but we shall see in a bit. Let's see how much room we've got. I just pulled that linkage off as well again. Then. Oh, that's tight. That all goes on. Now will that sit into there? Yeah, it will do just. That's pretty good. Right, let's hook up this spring one last time. So I know you can't see a great deal, but I'm trying to get my fingers in here too. That spring's just got a slight bend to it. Just bend that spring back. Don't know whether I've straightened that up a touch. That's better. Weird how that spring goes in the same hole as a governor, but it does. That one goes into there. Pull the spring a bit. That one goes onto there. That one goes into place. And now when that governor opens up, that's all going to move as freely as a bird. So that's good. Just got to bring this clamp down onto here, and then I'll come back to you. Right, that's the clamp now put on, and I just turn the spring around the other way as well, so it goes up through the hole. Seems to sit a bit better there. That's where the carb's going to sit, just there. And as you can see, the governor arm all works as it should do, like so. So hopefully that's in the right position. We're going to just turn this generator around now and start to reassemble it back together. Right. So that bottom lip just there, that goes on the bottom. So now I'm going to try and manipulate this all back together. That goes through the hole there, and the second one goes through the hole there, and it goes through the carb like so. Push them all the way home. It's just a question of just cradle all the bolts together, just watching it as you push them all in, so that you can definitely make sure they're home. That's one. And it's a question of offering it all up together till it all meets. And once it started off, this was not quite going in as well as I would like. That's better. I think that one's bitten. That one has yet.
yet. Got one, not the other, so I might as well just have to manipulate the carburetor. There's a hole, it's there somewhere. It'll find its way eventually. A bit fiddly fiddly. Don't want to round it off, that's a problem. No, that doesn't want it. I'm sure I've got one in. Yeah, that one's gone. Yeah, that one's definitely taken. So why don't that one want to take? Oh, I think it's got it now. Yeah, it's got it. Right, that's that one. And then we've got this one here, which goes down in this side, but I'm going to put a little tiny washer on the back side of that very quickly. Right, and there's one more to put in just here. I put a washer on the back of this bolt, just so it lines up a bit better. Just try and find the hole and line that up. Right, that's started. Now all of this should go in together. Just want to make sure that governor arm is moving as well, which I think it is. There's no other clips to hold this on, so this must sit tight once all this is all together. So let's put that carburetor on first. Pinch one end down before you pinch the other. That's it. That's just popped into place quite nicely now. That's still very, very loose. Let's screw this one down. That's got that one. Yeah, well, that's got that. Make sure the choke is working. Yeah, that's all working okay. What else do we have? Well, a bit of foam here, which is with your air intake. I'm not 100% certain why that is. I've only got one bit of foam just there. It doesn't seem to make a lot of sense why that's there, but that's what it is. I will give it a clean out later on. Just want to see if it gets get it to fire first. Little tiny cover. That goes on there like that. And then these Phillips screws. Gone all the way in. Yeah, must have done. Why is that screw not lined up? Yeah, it's gone in. Just starting to belt down the rain. Right. Happy with that. Now what I'm going to do, turn this around. I'm going to turn the fuel on. And I don't want to drain, drain the carburetor just yet, or flood the carburetor just yet. Just want to check for leaks first, make sure that no other leaks going on. So I'll give it 2 minutes and I'll come back. Right, that's not showing any leaks, which is good. Just now I'll try and flood this carburetor by loosening off this screw, which is at the bottom of the bowl. And by unturning that, I should better get some fuel down to the bottom of the bowl. So I should start to see fuel now dripping just here. You can see it. So that tells me we actually now have a carburetor that's now flooding. So tighten that back up. Happy with that. And we'll go for a little run up, shall we? Let's see what we can do. Make a bit of room. Put you guys up in the air. That there somewhere, and we'll see if we can get this this little old journey to fire up now. So HT lead is on, turn that on that way. Choke is that way, I think. Let's bring it around here. So you can see what's occurring. That's all working, that's all on. Choke is that way. Stop power, on power. Reset. Right, let's see what happens. Choke a bit. There you go. Let it run for a bit. Good. I'll just try and find something to plug in now and see if electrics work. Got a nice little grinder. Got a bit of a hunt to it, but some of these generators do have a bit of a hunt to them, especially the smaller jobbies. But if you want to just run it a bit quicker, you can just up the throttle on it ever so slightly. This side, it has got a bit of a throttle on it, so it says stop and choke, so it's in between. Let's just try and rev it up a bit more, just see if it start again. So it's gonna hunt there, just turn it up on the throttle, whatever, so slightly. It's gonna be about there. One seized generator that has not been running for God knows how long is now rocking and rolling. So super happy. All I'm going to do, I might just have a carburetor off one more time, just give it another clean up, and once I give it a run for about 15-20 minutes, I've just noticed I've got a little tiny drop of fuel there that might be coming out of a carburetor where I've been choking it, but I'll keep an eye on that. It could come out the fuel pipe as well, actually, so the fuel pipe may be a bit too big, so it could be one of those things. But hey ho, she's running, super happy, super impressed. Hopefully people like Bruce Pindat will be extremely proud of me with that, because I'm chuffed with it. So there you go, Bruce, that's the old Jenny done. There's it idling. better. Just tuning just ever so slightly on my idle. Much better.
So there you go. The Marksman generator now all up and running exactly how it should do, and just with a little tiny 3/4 of a turn on the idle screw, it has to stop that hunting. So that's good, good, good. That generator originally came to me, I thought it was to be seized, but with a little bit of work, it was unfreed very, very quickly. It fired up on the live stream, but now with a carburetor clean, which was absolutely shot and disgusting, that generator now runs pretty sweet, and also it powers all sorts of tools as well. I've been giving a variety of tests, different stuff. It's not the biggest gen in the world, but it's just a little tiny hobby caravan job, and it'll do a job. I'm very happy with it. So yeah, overall super pleased. So thank you very much for watching this episode of Micks Mowers. Hope you found it enjoyable, hope you found it informative. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. That helps towards the growth of my channel, and also to touch the bell notification, and that will tell you when I've released another video. For all of you that are new to my channel, don't forget to touch your subscribe button, and also that will also help towards the growth of my channel also. So thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you on the next episode of Micks Mowers. And until then, don't forget, take it easy.